While he waited, he returned to the beautiful sitting room and ate several of the red-cheeked apples to pass away the time. Meanwhile, Dorothy had dressed herself in a pretty gown of soft gray embroidered with silver, and put a blue and gold suit of satin upon little Button-Bright, who looked as sweet as a cherub in it, followed by the boy and Toto, the dog with a new green ribbon around his neck. She hastened down to the splendid drawing-room of the palace, where, seated upon an exquisite throne of carved malachite and nestled amongst its green satin cushions, was the lovely Princess Ozma, waiting eagerly to welcome her friend. End of chapter 19. Chapter 20. Princess Ozma of Oz. The royal historians of Oz, who are fine writers and know any number of big words, have often tried to describe the rare beauty of Ozma and failed because the words were not good enough. So, of course, I cannot hope to tell you how great was the charm of this little princess, or how her loveliness put to shame all the sparkling jewels and magnificent luxury that surrounded her in this her royal palace. Whatever else was beautiful or dainty or delightful of itself faded to dullness when contrasted with Ozma's bewitching face, and it has often been said by those who know that no other ruler in all the world can ever hope to equal the gracious charm of her manner. Everything about Ozma attracted one, and she inspired love and the sweetest affection rather than awe or ordinary admiration. Dorothy threw her arms around her little friend and hugged and kissed her rapturously, and Toto barked joyfully, and Button-Bright smiled a happy smile and consented to sit on the soft cushions close beside the princess. "Why didn't you send me word you were going to have a birthday party?" asked the little Kansas girl when the first greetings were over. "Didn't I?" asked Ozma, her pretty eyes dancing with merriment. "Did you?" replied Dorothy, trying to think. "Who do you imagine, dear, mixed up those roads so as to start you wandering in the direction of Oz?" inquired the princess. "Oh, I never suspected you of that," cried Dorothy.